In this video, I'm going to show how to see the execution log as administrator for Power BI Report Server. Please watch my previous video to know more about Power BI Report Server administrations in terms of identifying the specific properties for Power BI Report Server. Alright, so as you know, if you have installed your SQL Server reporting instances, you can see the reporting instances configuration. So in that case, we'll be using a database to store all the reporting elements. So the configuration of Power BI Report Server is same as like reporting instances, sorry, SQL Server reporting instances. So we have to configure the database to store all the Power BI related stuffs. So here I have created a database. So while configuring the Power BI Report Server, so I have created another video to install and configure the Power BI Report Server. So please watch that video to know more about what is the configuration part that you have to do for Power BI Report Server. So once you have configured and you are make sure your Power BI web portal is working and you are able to deploy the reports and also check the results in the web portal, so the next step of the administration is to identify the execution logs. So when you provide access to the end users, they'll be running their own reports for their understanding or to identify the insights from the data. So as administrator, we have to monitor the usage of the report, and if any issues, then we have to identify what query or what report is executing more time than the normal time. So we have to troubleshoot all the issues. So to troubleshoot those kind of issues, we have to go to Power BI Report Server database. So here I have created a database called Report Server underscore PBI. So under this database, you can see tables. So these are the tables that I have used to store all the stuffs related to the Power BI Report Server. So here if you see the tables, it is almost same. So inside the data will be new to the Power BI Report Server. So it is going to add only a specific section of data to the catalog and other related tables. I'm going to show how to differentiate this catalog table from your SQL Server reporting instances. So if you click catalog table, if you click select the top 1000, it's going to display all the results that you have deployed in your Power BI Report Server. So to differentiate that, you have to choose the type column. So here we have different values, 1, 2, 3, 12, 13, like that. So if you are working with SQL Server 2016, then you'll be familiar with the type called 12, which is just specific to mobile reports. Or if you are working with SQL Server prior version of SQL Server 2016, like SQL Server 2008, 8.2, and other SQL Server 2014 stuffs, so you can see, you can't see these types. So you'll be seeing type 1 to 9 or 1 to 10. So Microsoft SQL Server team has added a new type for mobile reports from SQL Server 2016. As we are talking about Power BI Report Server, they have added another new type, which is 13, which is specifically for Power BI reports. So I'm going to show the values and the key numbers. So one means folder, two report file. So like that, we have different definitions for each type numbers, and 12 means mobile report and 13 means Power BI report. So if you want to see only the execution log related to the Power BI, then you have to filter the type as 13 in your catalog table. Alright, let me show that. So here I have framed a query. So here I have used catalog table, and if you want to see all the execution, then you have to use execution log storage. So this table has what is the time start, time, and other related stuffs to monitor the execution of your reports. Here I have filtered the C type or catalog type equal to 13 to filter only the Power BI related stuffs. So these are the Power BI related reports that I have trend on this day today, and these are the other metrics that I have to taken care and I have to consider. If any issues with the performance, then I have to troubleshoot by changing the query which I used for the Power BI reports. So I'm going to show the portal. So this is my portal. As you can see, I have three different Power BI reports and mobile reports. So these are the reports have been executed. Those results will be added into the execution log storage. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel to know more about Power BI Report Server Administration part and Power BI Cloud Services Administration. Thank you.